Hi, Nikki. Welcome to your love reading. Let's see what Spirit has to say to you today regarding love. So, Spirit, tell me what's coming in love for Nikki. Be patient. Nobody ever likes that one in the love read. Be patient. Okay. What else, Spirit? Okay. Alright, hold on. Oh, goodness. Alright, so there's something kind of funky here, okay? So if you're currently in a connection, I'm gonna tell you that that connection is not good for you. This person's being very dishonest with you. If you are not in this connection, this is talking about your most recent relationships, okay? This is telling you that you've had the situation in the past, if you're not currently in this, okay? If you're in a current situation, you're about to find out some stuff, okay? All right, so what I'm picking up on, I'm gonna start here with these. First, you've got the card that says honesty is essential. This card typically comes out when you've got someone who is either not being fully honest with you about who they are and not living their truth, or that there's a third party involved. Regardless, this person is not who you think that they are, okay? There's a lot of deceit, there's a lot of jealousy and envy, and there's a lot of dishonesty, a lot, okay? I feel like this was a leap for you, that you took a chance on this, you know, with this person. Again, whether this was recent or if this is current, you really had to be brave and take a chance with this person. And Spirit's telling you that in reality, you weren't done healing. You weren't prepared to step into a relationship. And so Spirit's saying it's time for you to go back to what you love. Go back to your childhood hopes and dreams and the things that make you feel good inside. And go back and do the healing work that needs to happen in your childhood from those traumas. And don't think that just because something isn't where you think it should be or at a degree that you would like it to be at this moment in time, that it can't happen and it can't happen like that, okay? Because just like the lotus flower, when we go in and we go deep and we do that hard work in the thick of the mud and the dirty, nasty rawness of what is left behind from our traumas, and we deal with that, then when we heal, it's like we just shoot up so fast like the lotus, and it's this beautiful blossoming and unfolding of what is to come. So the other two cards that we got here, forgiveness needs to happen. One for you forgiving yourself for allowing yourself to step into something that you weren't prepared for and not doing the healing, right? But two, forgiving this person who has wronged you, who has cheated, who has not been honest and faithful in the relationship. And then this card again points to those inner childhood wounds that still need to be healed. So I want you to focus intentionally over the next little bit to be consistent with yourself, show up for yourself, do your meditations, do your journaling, focus on doing your shadow work so that you can be prepared for the true love that is going to come to you. Right now, it's a time to release all people, places, and things that no longer serve you and step into your healing.